Today, I'm here to talk to you about the most productive cover crop I have ever grown, and it far surpasses any legume that I've ever grown, and that is sorghum sudan grass. When I first started learning about cover crops, I wanted to grow legumes because I knew that they could fix nitrogen, and it did not make sense to me how plants that could not fix nitrogen would be able to survive without nitrogen, much less grow really, really well. I'm Rob from Dowdle Family Farms, and over the last 5 years, I've grown sorghum sudan grass, and it is by far the most productive, the most profitable, and the most effective cover crop I've ever grown. It can be used in a variety of different ways, as from a gardener to a row crop farmer, and especially for livestock farmers. Sorghum sudan grass is a warm season grass that is drought tolerant, and it grows in our area in Mississippi anyway from late April on into October or November, at least until our first frost of the year. It can produce 8 to 12 tons of dry matter per acre, at least that's the most that I've seen according to studies, but when I see it growing 10 or 12 feet tall and know that I can graze it or mow it 2, 3, sometimes even 4 times per grazing season, I wonder if it can produce a lot more biomass than just 12 tons of dry matter per acre. Now, if you live further north and you have a shorter window of time to grow warm season cover crops, it may not get that productive, but it is still huge. It has deep, thick roots that penetrate deep into the soil profile up to 4, 5, or even 6 feet deep. It has a lot of biomass in the roots, and I don't think they take that in consideration when they start talking about the forage. It's highly nutritious for livestock, and if you're trying to grow mulch on beds, it can produce a lot of mulch in a garden, and it does that really quickly and really easily as well. In addition to having deep roots and increasing the organic matter in the soil, the thing that I really love about sorghum sudan grass is it does not need a lot of nitrogen. The most I've ever fertilized our sorghum sudan grass is about 6 or 8 pounds of nitrogen, and that's only in the first year that we've grown it. Now, we often grow it with other crops like sunflowers or legumes, but I'm just here to tell you, even grown by itself, sorghum sudan grass will take a little while to get started. The root exudates from the sorghum sudan grass help feed the soil life, and it does not need a whole lot of nitrogen. We'll come back to that nitrogen in a moment when we start talking about grazing it with livestock. Now, in terms of managing sorghum sudan grass, you can plant it with a no-till seed drill. I usually have a light disking or tilling that I use over the soil, and then I cover it up and it grows really well. It takes it about a week to germinate. It's a little bit slow to start, and then it just takes off. If sorghum sudan grass is either grazed or mown within the first month or so before it goes to seed, it'll actually produce a lot more biomass in the roots, and those roots will penetrate even deeper into the soil profile. Before it's grazed, a lot of times it's 2 to 3 feet deep. After it's grazed, a lot of times it's 4 to 6 feet deep from the studies that I've read. Again, I don't dig up our pasture trying to find the roots for sorghum sudan grass, but I can tell just from the above ground roots that I see tillering out that it does produce a lot more roots after it's grazed and mown. We usually terminate our sorghum sudan grass cover crop through really heavy grazing, or we turn our pigs into it. Sorghum sudan grass can go to seed, and it will regrow from that seed. In our pastures, it doesn't matter, but just know that it might do that. The biggest issue with managing sorghum sudan grass is if you're going to be grazing it with your livestock. There are two things where it can harm livestock, and that's with prussic acid or nitrate poisoning. I'm not going to get into the biology and the chemistry of both of those because I don't understand it. But from a practical perspective, to avoid prussic acid poisoning, what you need to do is let it grow at least 18 to 24 inches before grazing it. You must rotate your cattle off of it because regrowth or first growth is where prussic acid is. Also, if sorghum sudan grass is stressed by drought, it can have prussic acid. Prussic acid can also be an issue with sorghum sudan grass after the first frost. Now, normally after a few days, that prussic acid poisoning risk is really low, but just know that you need to look that up and manage it really carefully. You must have good fences around your sorghum sudan grass because it can harm your livestock. Nitrate poisoning is another thing. I don't understand why people would apply a lot of nitrogen to sorghum sudan grass. It grows really well without it. Nitrate poisoning is when it absorbs too much nitrogen, whether it's a nitrate, nitrite, or some other form, and it stays within the plant rather than the plant growing. When livestock consume it, that nitrate goes into their blood. It removes oxygen and the livestock suffocate. If you look on the extension websites, a lot of times the recommendations for sorghum sudan grass can be anywhere up to 90 or even 120 pounds of nitrogen per acre. I do not understand that. This is based on my experience, not on research. But in my observation, we can get real thick, real tall, 6 or 8 foot growth cycles 3 or 4 times a year with sorghum sudan grass, and it does really well without nitrogen. So we do not fertilize any more than just a few pounds on the first time we grow sorghum sudan grass in a really worn out field. I would recommend that you look into more information on prussic acid poisoning and nitrate poisoning for your area, but just know it is some concern. I'll talk about how to manage grazing sorghum sudan grass in another video later this summer, hopefully. Now, when we start talking about the uses of sorghum sudan grass, obviously its use for soil improvement is huge. The thing about sorghum sudan grass that makes it the most productive, it's not just that it has a high production capacity for forage. It's not just that you don't have to put a whole lot of inputs into sorghum sudan grass to produce that high forage. The thing that is that makes sorghum sudan grass the most productive crop that I've ever grown is it does all that without a lot of inputs, and it improves the health of the soil on your farm or in your garden in ways that you could not have imagined. I mean, it is absolutely huge. After growing sorghum sudan grass for one season, we had a drought the second season, and the areas where we had grown sorghum sudan grass had about 1.5 to 2 weeks longer of growth before it was struck by drought. That doesn't sound like a whole lot of an issue, but the thing is an extra week or two of growth is a lot of productivity. Obviously, the second reason is it produces a lot of good, high-quality forage for your livestock. I like to grass finish our beef on sorghum sudan grass. They grow really well, they perform really well, and it is a match made in heaven. And finally, we feed our pigs on sorghum sudan grass. I've never grazed pigs on green-growing sorghum sudan grass, but after it dies out in the fall, it's amazing to see the pigs go through, knock down the stalks, and eat the stalks that the cows didn't want to eat. And I think they're going after the sugars and the sorghum sudan grass. It provides a great filler, especially for our breeding sows. I really like that a lot about it. Finally, sorghum sudan grass can also provide a good mulch to the soil. Maybe you don't have something growing during the summer and you want to grow your own mulch for your fall vegetable garden. Grow sorghum sudan grass, knock it down, kill it, and it is amazing how much of a mulch it'll form on the soil. If you've grown sorghum sudan grass, let me know what you think of it. Have you had problems growing sorghum sudan grass, whether for your livestock or for your garden beds? Let me know. Leave a comment in the description below. Share this video with somebody you think it might find it helpful. And until next time, it's Rob from Dowdle Family Farms wishing you the best. Take care and have an absolutely wonderful day.